Reading from the Dead Sea Scrolls Bible, the oldest known Bible translated for the first time into English, the great Isaiah Scrolls, written by the prophet Yeshayahu, 700 years before Christ, and copied by the priests that had been and separated themselves from the politics of Jerusalem. I'm reading today from the 29th chapter, verse where it begins like, ah, Anil, Anil, the city where David encamped. And year to year, let the feasts come round. Then I will distress Anil, and there will be mourning and lamentation, and she will be to me as Anil. And I will encamp against you all around, and will lay siege against you with towers, and I will raise siege works against you, and you will be brought down, and will speak from the ground, and your speech will be low from the dust. Your voice will be like that of a ghost from the ground, and your speech will whisper from the dust. But the multitude of your enemies will be like fine dust, and the multitude of ruthless ones like chaff that blows away. Suddenly, in an instant, you will be punished by Jehovah Sabaoth with thunder, with an earthquake, and great noise, with whirlwind and tempest and flame of devouring fire. And the multitude of all the nations that fight against Anul, even all that fight against her and her fortification, and distress her, will be like a dream, a vision of the night. And it will be as when a hungry man dreams, and see, he eats but awakes and is empty. It will be like when a thirsty man dreams, and see, he drinks, but wakes up faint and is still thirsty. So be the multitude of all the nations be that fight against Mount Zion. Tarry and wonder. Take your pleasure and be blind. They are drunken, but not from wine. They stagger.
Starbucks
not
might,
with strong
Starbucks
drink.
Might be hiring. Do you want to get a job and make some money?
For the Jehovah has poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep, and has closed your eyes, you prophets, and he has covered your heads, you seers. And this whole vision has become to you like the words of a book that is sealed, which people deliver to one who is learned, saying, read this, I pray you. But he says, I cannot, for it is sealed. Then they deliver the book to one who is not learned, saying, read this, I pray you. But he says, I am not learned. And Jehovah said, inasmuch as this people draw near to honor me with their mouth and with their lips, but have removed their hearts far from me, and fear of me has been like a human command that has been taught them. Therefore, see, as for me, I am about to do a marvelous work among this people, even a marvelous work and a wonder. And the wisdom of the wise men will perish, and the insights of the prudent men will be hidden. Woe to those who hide deep their counsel from Jehovah, and in whose works have been in the dark, and who say, who sees us, and who has known us? He has overturned things from you. Will it be thought of like the potter's heart? The potter's, will it be thought of like the potter's heat? So that the thing made should say of the one who made it, he did not make me, or the thing formed say of the one who formed it, he has no understanding. Is it not yet a very little while, and Lebanon will be turned into a fruitful field, and the fruitful field will be regarded as a forest. And on that day, the deaf will hear the words of the book, and the eyes of the blind will see out of the gloom and darkness. The meek also will increase their joy in Jehovah, and the poor among men will rejoice in the Holy One of Israel. For the terrible one is brought to naught, and the scoffer ceases, and all who watch for iniquity are cut off. Those who make a man an offender in his cause, and lay a snare for him who reproves in the gate, and turn aside the just with meaningless arguments. Therefore, thus says Jehovah, who redeemed Abraham, concerning the house of Jacob, Jacob will not now be ashamed, neither will his face now grow pale. But when he sees his children, the work of my hands, in the midst of him, they will sanctify my name. Yes, they will sanctify the Holy One of Jacob, and will stand in awe of the Elohim of Israel. Moreover, those who err in spirit will come to understanding, and those who complain will receive instruction. For as a prophet from the mouth of Jehovah, we find it in the words of the rebuke of Israel before they're being carried into captivity, were many and strong wind from many prophets. Many prophets were sent speaking them to repent. The wicked kings killed the prophets, the good kings let them speak. But there was still reproof because the people as a whole had not turned from their wicked ways. In the Torah it's taught that principle of a man being his brother's keeper. In other words, I'm saying that there is responsibility in society for all of society. It cannot be that one man go wicked and the society does not suffer. So there is a social responsibility for all to reprove the neighbor, to encourage what is good, do what is right. Let's curse be upon all the land. We've been seeing since it was the spring of 2020, a plague hit the land, and it's not the first time, but it's the first time in recent history. In an age of information where news spreads fast, and so do plagues. But the answer to the plague is to repent, all you peoples and all you lands. The answer to the rebuke of Jehovah is to repent from all your wicked ways. In Seattle, Washington, you don't have to go too far before you see a sign out, someone selling the palm reading, spiritualists, fortune tellers. There's stories that sell things of witchcraft. And there are many people that say that they are their God. Many people living in delusion believe that you live and you die and it's all over, so they enjoy what pleasure they can. But we have this testimony that life doesn't end when your mortal body is laid down to sleep. Many people have seen heaven and come back to speak. I myself, I've seen heaven, I've seen hell. I've experienced miracles, and I know this book is very, very really, the author of this book is not a series of men who wrote a certain line of thought, but know that there is a one author who spoke to his prophets, and he gave him his instruction from the beginning. And now is still a time while the human race, the land of decision, in the valley of decision, are still tested day by day, that your works be known. Our Father in heaven, he loves all his children, and has spoken to his prophets even while the children of Israel were in captivity in the land of Babylon. While they had been taken away for the wicked deeds, Father still spoke to his people as the father speaks to his child. A child who is punished with seclusion in the room. A loving parent doesn't leave in the misery, but seeks a way to reconcile and to cause resolution to whatever issues there may be, that there may be peace in the house and in the heart of their child. And likewise, our Father has sent teachers, he sent prophets, he sent pastors, he has sent throughout all the generations those who comfort his people and speak of the ways of life. In 1988, in November, and I was working construction, and my back went out because I'm not a crane. He had me to pick up a big exterior wall made with 2x6s and headers, and my back went out three places, and it didn't look like I was going to ever be able to work again. And I called out to our Father in heaven and said, I thought you opened this door, but Father, please have mercy upon me. According to your love and kindness and tender mercies. As I prayed, I felt a hand the length of my whole back, and it's rolled down my spine, and every bone went into place. And then he told me he didn't want me building houses, he wanted to preach his kingdom, that his love may be spread abroad openly. I know that many are bound with the devil and are full of hate, but love is a one thing all people need. I don't care how much you hate, you need love. I don't care how bitter you are, you need the sweetness of your Father's love. I don't care how much you distance yourself from humanity and thinking that you're like an alien walking amidst everybody else. You have a Father in heaven. You're not an orphan. Your Father lives. I have seen the King. I've seen a Father. And I have this message. But thus says the King, I have seen your travail, and I have been with you, I watch you, and I have my servants for watching over you and caring for you. The time is very short, and here and now, I here welcome you into my everlasting arms and care. Lay aside every burden and every care, and I will give you peace. I will give you salvation. This is the voice of He who created the heavens and the earth. His word does not go out and come back void. It's impossible for the creator of the universe to lie, because what He speaks comes to pass. And therefore, as He has spoken this salvation, it is sure. You would never be ashamed if you would trust in Jehovah Elohim. You could trust in the Lord our God. If you would trust in the Savior of the world. Religion will not save anybody. Religion cannot justify anybody, because religion is based upon the opinions of men. But a relationship with your Father is what your father desires. Your father desires to speak with you and to hold you and to give you everlasting life. You can find the truth in my words when you pray and you trust him in your healing, when you trust him in making a way out of no way. For he is good and he is a reward of all that trust in him. My eyes have seen the King and my ears have heard the voice of the Almighty. I declare this thing that is true. This love endures forever. When Israel was down and out and it appeared, they would be scattered across the face of the earth and never be restored. When there was no cause for hope and everything seemed to be lost, they still had the love of the Father. Our Father in heaven brought his people out of the land of bondage over and over and over again. He's still bringing his children out of the land of bondage. He's still saving souls. He's still justifying all that trust in him and believe on him. What I'm talking about, I'm talking about a love that endures beyond faith, beyond hope. And this is of the love of our Father. Yeah, you may be numbered among the transgressors, but if you repent in the name of he who laid down his life to pay your ransom, to pay the penalty of your sins, to redeem your soul, you will find victory. Victory in this life and the ages to come. If you seek the Lord with all your heart, all your soul, you will hear his voice and know him in the pardon of your sins, a healing of your body, restoration of your soul. This is the good news. This is the gospel of the kingdom. Blessed be his name.